Hello and welcome to this tutorial. I'm Peter Sandell and an application engineer at Vector Sweden. This video is about getting to know the different factors that control what you see in PREEvision. The artifacts, details, diagrams, editors, and other things can be configured to be displayed or hidden in many ways. Some differences are substantial while others are subtle and only seen after a thorough look. The mechanisms behind this diversity of what is shown are several. First, there is the license and the user role. The selected product license sets boundaries of what is possible to access within PREEvision. This schematic image shows a complete overview of the EE engineering solution. But what artifacts and functions that can be viewed, used, or accessed depends upon the active license and sets an absolute limit to what can be utilized. The architect license is without any restrictions, while all other license models limits the access in some way to some parts. The user role settings are made in the authority model, where authority items and authority groups create a set of rights common for the user role. This controls access to projects, model artifacts classes, and tool functionality such as actions and views. A user role must be connected to the active account when working server-based to be able to log in at all. Both the license and the user role are controlled by administrators with elevated rights and can likely not be edited by you. Second, there is the scopes that control what data that is important and on display in the model view. In a server-based environment, you must specify what subset of the model database you will work with by activating a scope. Through limiting what is loaded to the cache of the client, both unnecessary model complexity is hidden and the PC workload is reduced. Scopes can likely be controlled and edited by you, but depends upon the rules set by your organization. They have no impact in what editors, views, menu options, and such that are shown. If you see artifacts you need are missing in the model view, it is possible to both extend the scope or temporarily add it to the currently active one. For scopes, there is a whole other pre-learning tutorial where these things are presented more in detail. Third, we have the perspectives, the filters, and the user preferences, that all three can be controlled by you. What perspective you should use depends upon your intended usage, what your task or assignment is. They are made to support different use cases as and a big impact to the appearance of the GUI. Perspectives control the layout and other things such as content of the main toolbar, menus, open views, and editors. But apart from having defined filters in the configuration, perspectives themselves do not control access to or hide certain artifacts. Also, the concept of perspectives is covered in another tutorial. Filters help you find what you need in tables, views, and editors that all may contain a lot of information. Compared to scopes that define and describe what should be shown, filters work in the opposite way by excluding what should not be shown, such as details, classes, or levels in the hierarchy. This makes it easier to navigate and find and work with the details of interest. Filters can in general at any time be turned off and on and configured. They are found in tables, diagrams, views, and editors. In the Preferences dialog, many settings can be made that alters both what is shown and how PREEvision behaves. The options to change colors, behavior, look and feel, and functionality are many. The button Restore Defaults make it safe to try out what settings that you prefer.